everybody. My name is Matthew Barboza, and I am joined by my broadcasting partner, Clay Thompson. And we're here at the Hulker Memorial Field. Oh, I do believe I mispronounced that. Hulker Memorial Field at Southeastern Regional. It's a beautiful day for football, especially the first game of the season for both teams.
Thank you, Matt. As you said, we are at the Hulker Memorial Field at Southeastern. It's a wonderful day. The sun is starting to go down, so the warm heat should be going away. A little bit windy, but shouldn't be too much of a problem. It's a great day to watch some football.
Thanks, Clay. And the first game of the season, some could say, is the most important game of the whole season because, well, everyone wants to start their season off with a win. But, unfortunately, only one team's going to have that dream come true between these two teams. The Coyle and Cassidy High School, they won the coin toss, and they have elected to receive. So Southeastern will kick from right to left. The kick. The ball has been caught, and it is being ran down the field. A tackle at what appears to be the 45-yard line. I mean, 33-yard line. It is first and 10. Do you have any thoughts on that play?
Seemed pretty interesting. Good tackle.
That was a good tackle, actually. There appears to be an issue with the ball, so they're getting a second one. I'm incorrect about that. With the snap, running back runs with the ball. Gets stopped dead.
Oscar on the carry, no gain. Second down and 10.
It is still second and 10. There appears to be no activity on the field. Here's the snap, another running play, and he is tackled. What do you think about
Oscar
that play, Clay?
Carry, brought down for a loss by Southeastern.
Went over pretty quick. Southeastern seems to be holding up pretty good so far.
I would agree. And that was, if you're having a little issue seeing, that was a loss on the play. Third and 11. They lost a single yard on that play. Third and 11. They're going to have to make a first down on the next two plays. Quarterback throws it, and it is caught by number 3 of Henry Brecher. It is 4-3. Now, I would go with they're going to go for a running play instead of kicking it because they're so close to the first down. What do you think, Clay?
It's definitely a possibility, but you never know. They could just surprise you.
I would agree. They're lining up for the ball. They're in pump formation. And they do kick it. That was a surprise to me. Well, that was interesting. Don't you agree?
Yes, the Hawks now have the ball thanks to the Warriors kicking it.
And the Hawks, so far, good defense. Again, first game of the season, first time we really get to see this defense in game form. Southeastern ran. there appeared to be a gain of yardage. It is 2nd and 6 with 7 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the game. Sorry, in the first quarter. That was an error on my part. With the snap and the running play, and he is brought down, and someone appears to be injured. Everyone appears to be fine. There was unusual whistling activity. What do you think that could have been?
Who knows? Maybe the ref saw what could have been a penalty, but that's a little bit far for me to see.
Yeah, and we have a screen in front of us. It's kind of hard to see through the screen. But we're making it work. And it's 3rd and 6, still. Oh, that was amazing. He broke that tackle. He broke another tackle. Oh, he is like butter. Oh, he got hit hard.
That was rather impressive. I just sliding right through everyone.
Yeah, got it. They're still at the 6-yard line, but that was an amazing play. We appear to be in kicking formation. With the snap and the kick. It is caught. Colin Cassidy has possession of the ball now after neither team could really even make a first down. Either both teams are seriously lacking in offense or they are. Either both teams have a subpar offense, no offense to anyone who are a fan of either of these teams, or both teams have an impeccable defense. We'll have to see which one's true. With the snap, given to the running back. Oh, that appeared to be helmet-on-helmet contact. What do you think?
Well, let's just hope that those helmets are designed correctly and no one's hurt.
Yeah. It was a gain of 6, and it is 2nd and 4. That big guy was rather amazing. Took, I think, 3 people to tackle him. That's pretty good. I mean, yeah, it's pretty good. With the snap, given to the running back. Running back runs through, almost breaks his tackle. He does break the tackle. He is making it to the end zone. He has made it to the end zone for the first touchdown of the game. The time is 4 minutes, 14 seconds left in the first quarter, and the score is now 6. It is now Warriors 6, Southeastern 0, and I believe that touchdown was by Tanner Costa. It was. It was a 48-yard touchdown run. Right there. That was an amazing play. What do you think about that play?
It was rather impressive. He got the ball, and he just ran. He didn't stop. He broke through some tackles. Good on him.
I, for one, thought he was going to get downed at that one tackle where they got him by the waist, but he just broke that tackle. They're lining up to kick the point. For all you people, that's a field goal, 1 point. And it is stuffed. That was a no good field goal. That was amazing. That ball got stuffed. That must have hurt. That must have hurt a lot. The Hawks have possession of the ball after what appears to be a short timeout. What was your opinion on that, though, Clay?
Well, everything seems to be fairly interesting in this game. It's still early, though, and one touchdown can be enough to win, but we'll see in a little bit.
Always insightful knowledge from our friend Clay. The Southeastern Hawks are in return position. They get the ball. And the number 21 of... Ooh! That was an amazing tackle by... Richard Carlton. Or Carlton Richard. Yeah, Carlton Richard, sorry. He got the ball. He ran. That was an impressive tackle. Impressive run. It is... First and 10 at, I believe, the 25-yard line. They're approaching the ball, as you can clearly see. All right, and the run. And he gets brought down. Prior to the 40 line line. It is second and three. What do you think about that play, Clay?
Well, it didn't last too long, so Coyle and Cassidy has fairly decent defense, and the Hawks are going to need to step up their offense a little bit if they're going to tie up the score or get it into their favor.
Now, Southeastern lost a good portion of their players to graduating. Play is dead. The ball is dead. It was a short gain.
Good enough for a first down.
And, gain of over three, so that is a first down. First down of the game. That's very good for Southeastern. They have achieved something that the Cole Cassidy Warriors have not achieved. Up first down. It is first and 10 at the 36-yard line. Oh, the throw is incomplete. But that may be pass interference. That may have been pass interference. We'll wait to see if there was a flag on the play.
Second down and 10 for the Hawks.
There was no flag on the play. That looked like pass interference, but I'm not too sure. I didn't have the best look at it. What do you think, Clay?
Well, just like you, I didn't have a great look at it. It stinks that the Hawks weren't able to catch the ball, but there's still plenty of time in the game.
Yeah, there is over three quarters left. Oh, the running play is stopped. Ball is dead. I believe they gained 3 yards. So it is now third and 7. Again, as I said earlier, I don't believe I finished the statement. Southeastern has lost a lot of their good players to a thing I like to call graduating. Oh, running play.
Richard on the carry. Short gain, it'll be fourth down and 6.
It is fourth and 6, a gain of about 1 yard with 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter. What do you think about this quarter so far, Clay?
Well, the Warriors are in the lead, of course, since they've gotten a touchdown. But Southeastern has shown potential in both their defense and offense. So within the next three quarters. Hopefully they'll be able to pull into the lead and win the first game of the season.
I hope that happens too. Oh, they're in punt formation. Nice punt straight up in the air. Number nine has it. Number nine is brought to, ooh! That was a tough tackle on number nine. I believe Tanner Costa. I do believe he scored the first touchdown. What do you think of that tackle, Clay?
Well, that was really impressive. Took him straight down. That was good.
Ball is going to the right end of the field. I, for one, hope it does not go all the way to the right, because that would mean another touchdown, but there's still enough time in the game. And there is a timeout on the field. The Highland Cassidy, the Hawks have called a timeout. But the timeout appears to be done. Yep. Oops. Yep.
Second down.
It is second. It's second and 11. With under a minute remaining in the first quarter. Seconds remaining in the first quarter. And the play is about to begin. I am correct. The ball is thrown. It is caught. Beautiful catch. Don't you agree?
Yes, he caught it. He went down and didn't get to run, but he still caught it and they gained some yards.
Henry Brecher is really good. Like, he's one of the names that I think we're going to hear a lot in this game. The clock is frozen at 22.9 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Players are back on the field after what appears to be a huddle. It is third and 11. Oh, that pass may have been incomplete, actually. I think it was. Oh, brought down. Ooh. Got any comments on that play, Clay?
Oh, he took him straight down. Feel bad for him. That must have hurt.
It must have hurt. No gain on the play. Boy, that was. Quarter over. The score at the end of the first quarter is Cole Cassidy Warriors 6. Southeastern Hawks 0. So far, this has been an overall amazing, amazing quarter. What do you think were some of your favorite moments, Clay?
Well, it was really great when Southeastern was breaking through tackle after tackle after tackle. I found that very impressive. While we didn't gain any yards, it was still good on us, and it shows great potential for the later parts in the game.
One of my favorite plays so far was when the guy in the Hawks, I don't know specifically who it was, but Cole Cassidy was going for the kick, and he just jumped in front of the ball, took the hit to the chest. It looked like it hurt, but I don't know. It's a good play.
So the first quarter is over, and the players seem to be getting ready for the second quarter. With any luck, the Hawks will be able to pull through and get a touchdown, hopefully more. We have a 4th down and 14 for Coyle and Cassidy. And the ball is kicked. Picked up by Southeastern. He runs, he breaks through 2 tackles. Oh, taken down by the 3rd, fumble. Can't see who has it though.
It appears to be a flag on the play. But might not be. Oh, and Southeastern has lost the ball.
Fumble is recovered by Coyle Cassidy. It'll be first down Warriors.
First down Warriors. First down at the 45-yard line. That was unfortunate because that was a good play. With the snap, it is given to the running back of number 9. He drops it, fumble. Southeastern appears to have recovered it, and they have. They lost the ball in one play. They recovered it on the next. That was good. Don't you agree?
Yes, we are net 0, minus 1, plus 1. We're back to where we started.
That was good. Southeastern must be feeling pretty good about themselves right now. This kind of thing actually... it happens more often than you think. One team fumbles it, then the next play they get it back, be it interception or another fumble.
First down and 10 Hawks.
First and 10 Hawks. Oh. It's brought down.
Second down and 9.
It's 2nd and 9. It's 2nd and 9 with 9 minutes and 15 seconds to halftime. And with the snap, and the quarterback's going to throw it. He throws it, and it is caught. It is caught by number 17, and he's running.
Pass complete to Tibbetts.
The pass was to Ryan Tibbetts. Can't really see what happened, but both teams kind of freaked out right there. That was a tackle at the 42-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 7. What? 8 minutes, 20 seconds remaining to halftime. Clay, what are your opinions on that previous play?
Well, Tibbetts did a good job. He caught the ball, which is always good to do, and then he managed to break through a tackle while he still seemed to trip over himself from it, but he managed to keep it in his hands and not lose possession of the ball, which is always nice.
Up, and... running play with a gain of yardage. That was a good gain of yardage. First down Hawks. He was brought down at the 32-yard line. All right, Southeastern, first and 10 Hawks, and Southeastern, we're going for a touchdown. Oh, flag on the play. Possible offsides, possible delay of game. We'll find out in a couple of seconds. False start. Ball.
That's a 5-yard penalty.
Ball start on the Hawks. 5-yard penalty. First and 15. Clay, what were your opinions on that?
Well, it really stinks. I mean, the Hawks just got their first down, and then they had to lose 5 yards over a penalty. Hopefully, it won't happen again.
Yeah, and it'd be unfortunate if we lost because of that, because I remember seeing some football games where 5 yards was the definition between winning and losing. Especially in a drive late in the game. But you know what? This is still early. Number 7 goes for the throw. It is caught by the 21. He is running. Oh! Ooh, brought down by the legs. Number 21 of Carlton Richard made that catch. Ran.
Nice gain.
Big gain. Gonna go with the really close to the first down. And it is a first down. That is very good. Don't you agree, Clay?
Very good indeed. Southeastern is getting closer to the end zone. Hopefully we'll get a touchdown. We did a really good job at avoiding being tackled sooner. I'll definitely say that. So hopefully we'll keep this up and tie up the score pretty soon.
I hope we not tie up the score. I hope we make the kick. I hope the kick is good. Because that way we'll be leading by 1 point. But hey, point's a point no matter how you get it. Oh, running back is brought down. A lot of running plays this game. It is second. It's second down. Now, the time is 5 minutes 53 seconds remaining in the second quarter, or remaining to halftime. It's second and 9. Oh, the running play. I do believe that was a loss in yards.
Because
he got launched. Still 39. I was incorrect about that loss in yardage. Clay, what was your opinion on that last play?
Well, to be honest, a gust of wind blew, some papers fell down, I picked them up, and I missed it.
I actually forgot about that. Sorry for calling you out on that.
It happens.
All right. Oh, with the running play, he breaks through. Brought down. But that looks really close to a touchdown.
Knocked out of bounds. Let's see what he
Hopefully the official gives us enough yards for a
fourth and four.
I'm going to assume they go for it because they're close, really close to a first down. They might as well go for it. It'd be worth it. And I do believe they are going for it because, yeah. Ball's thrown. Cut! Touchdown, Southeastern.
Pass in the end zone is caught for a touchdown.
Touchdown, Southeastern. Score. Yeah. Score is 6-6. Time 4:40 remaining to halftime.
Do we know who got the touchdown?
Amazing play. Waiting to find out who got the touchdown, though. About a 17-yard touchdown. We will inform you who got the touchdown as soon as we receive word on who got the touchdown. Southeastern's going for the two-point conversion.
Say what?
They did not get the two-point conversion. We did not get that two-point conversion, unfortunately. It is still 6-6. Some of you people who it's about the first time watching a football game,
Like, I'd hope not, because you're watching high school football. Anyways, for some of you people that don't know, if they had gotten to the end zone in that play, the score would have been 8-6 instead of 7-6, because a two-point conversion is worth 2 points, and a kickoff field goal is only worth one after a touchdown. But if you kick it and it goes in and you haven't just previously scored a touchdown on the previous play, it would be worth three points. We have just received word that number four of David Burns has caught the football. I repeat, number four of David Burns has caught the ball for that touchdown pass.
That touchdown pass.
And you know what? That was a good pass. Up, and the Warriors got the ball, and he is brought down. I actually believe he had gone farther up, but he lost yards.
First and 10, Coyle Cassidy inside the 25-yard line.
First and 10 for Coyle Cassidy. 4 minutes, 34 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Coyle Cassidy. Oh, running play. He broke one tackle, got tackled by the next person. It was gain of four. It is now second and six. What was your opinion on that last play, Clay?
Well, the Warriors haven't reached the 50-yard line. It's only about 4 minutes left, and hopefully we won't let them get to that 50-yard line.
And appears to have been a three-yard game. It appears to have been a three-yard gain. From what I saw, it'll be third and three. This play is going to, I think it's going to be running play, and it is. Tackle broken. It is now fourth down.
Ball on the ground, recovered by Southeastern.
It is now, it was a fumble, and Southeastern recovered. Good job for them. Clay, what do you think about that play?
Well, it went over quick, so we know that Southeastern is moving fast, and they really want to get another touchdown to hopefully win this game quicker.
I completely agree. Up. Oh, that was a nasty tackle.
Richard on the carry.
Play is dead. Ball is dead.
Gain of about five.
It was a gain of five.
Second and five. Hawks.
I repeat, Hawks are second and five. What do you think about that play, Clay?
Well, we didn't move as much as most of you would have liked, but we're moving up, which is always a good thing.
You are correct on that. Oh, running play again. And he is brought down.
Shay Derry on the carry. Close to a first down.
It was close to a first down. And, you know, I hope it's really close to a first down, not just close to a first down.
Third down and about three.
Third and three. This play is going to be interesting. I can see. It is. I think it's a QB sneak.
Quarterback keeper.
Was a QB sneak. I think that's what it's called.
Knocked out of bounds, but he got a first down Hawks.
First down Hawks. 1 minute, 30 seconds remaining. It is still 6-6.
Timeout on the field. Southeastern.
So the Hawks just got their first down, although they were tackled out of bounds, but the first down is still a good thing nonetheless. So hopefully we can stay in bounds when we can help it, and we will continue to advance towards the end zone and hopefully take the lead of the game.
A no gain of yardage.
10 yards to go
with a minute and 13 remaining in the second period. One minute remaining. Preparing for the play. I, for one, believe they're about to get a touchdown before the beginning of, before halftime. I think they're going to get a touchdown. Brought down.
Ryan
clock
Tibbetts
is stopped. Ryan Tibbetts with the carry.
Gain of five. Timeout on the field.
And there is a timeout.
43 seconds left to go here in the first half.
Well, so far this has been an eventful first half. I hope the rest of the game is as exciting as it's been so far. Don't you agree, Clay?
Most definitely. With 43 seconds to go and we are so close to the end zone. We don't know what's going to happen next. There's no way we can predict it. Maybe we'll run out of time. Maybe we'll get into the end zone. Let's hope for the latter, though.
Most definitely. It's actually a pretty windy day today. All right, this music. This sure is some exhilarating music. Third and five with 43.2 seconds remaining till halftime. Hopefully Hawks did what they did the last time they were at third and they were at a third down and they score another first down. That's what I hope. Let's see if that happens. They're going for a throw. He is almost intercepted. Almost, but almost isn't good enough. He was almost sacked.
And five to go.
It'll be fourth and five. You know, it's so windy. I would say going for a going for a punt, not a punt, a three-point field goal. It wouldn't even be worth it because it's so windy. You'll just risk missing a chance for a touchdown. Might as well go for it right now. Plus, you're so close to the end zone. If you kick it, they'll start at the 20-yard line. Unless you can kick it straight up in the air. Quarterback's going for the throw. He almost gets sacked. No one was even paying attention to that throw.
Pass is incomplete.
Pass is incomplete. Warriors have the ball. First and 10 for Coyle Cassidy. About 31.1 seconds remaining to the second half of the game. The Warriors are on offense, but that is a pretty far distance to go in only 30 seconds. And they are brought down.
Quarterback keeper. Brought down after a 6-yard game.
Brought down after a 6-yard game, and the clock appears to be about to run out.
No
15.
Timeout on the field. Second down and three.
10. It is second and three. You know what? They're just going to let the clock run out. There's no way they're getting a play in. And the clock has ran out.
That'll do it for the first half. Our score.
First half, 6-6 each. And we'll come back to the second half after this.
Let's hear it for the Coyle Cassidy cheerleaders.
Okay, you ready?
Yep.
That's for them?
Yeah, that's for.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's hear it again from Coyle Cassidy cheerleaders. And now your Southeastern Regional cheerleaders.
Which one do you want me to do first?
If you want to do that one first while I get the ticket,
yeah.
That's good.
Let's hear it again for the Southeastern Regional Hawk cheerleaders. For all of you parents of football players and Southeastern cheerleaders, we could really use some volunteers to help out in the snack shack. If you are interested in helping out at a future Southeastern football game, please see the cheerleading coach behind the football bench during the second half. Please volunteer your time to help a very worthy cause. And now we're going to announce the winner of tonight's 50-50 raffle. And the winner, get out your ticket. The winner of tonight's 50-50 raffle, a red ticket, number 588-609. 588-609. If you have that ticket, please come up to the press box and claim your prize. Congratulations.
My wallet's in my bag. Down on the track.
second half, all that. All
right. Oh, welcome back, everybody, to the second half of this exciting football game. As the previous half, I'm Matthew Barboza. I'm joined by Clay Thompson. Let's hope that we do this whole game in a good way.
That's right, Matt. Currently, the score is tied 6-6. The third quarter shall be starting shortly. The players are all lining up. Again, we are tied 6-6. The players are lining up. Hopefully, the Hawks can pull through and get the win.
Most definitely, whichever team wins this game, it's going to be a hard-fought victory. With the kickoff, the ball is gained. Oh! Ooh! And there's a flag on the play. There is a flag on the play, and that was a good play. I wonder what the flag could have been. Hopefully nothing too major, just a minor penalty. I'd hate to see this game win, be won off of penalties. I would love to see the game.
Holding on the Hawks,
all right. Penalty for the Hawks. They will lose yards on that play. What do you think about that call, Clay?
Well, I mean, holding is holding. Don't do it if you play football.
That's actually a really good opinion. That's an amazing opinion. Don't be holding. And the play has begun. It is given to the running back. Oh, he breaks. Oh, a couple tackles. Shame to see him go. It's shame to see him go down so early, but he did.
5 yard
game. Second and five for the Hawks. That was a great run. Minutes, 20 seconds left in the game. 9 minutes, 18 seconds left in this quarter. This is the third quarter. Running play. Ooh. That was a pretty violent tackle. What do you think?
That definitely was violent, as you said. He was right in the air, got taken down by the legs. Hopefully he's okay.
He was actually taken Southeastern first down, but what may not have been picked up as well on the camera is that he fumbled the ball, but only after he was tackled down. He fumbled after the ball was dead, so that was a pretty hard tackle to fumble. He must have been hit pretty hard. It amazes me how they can do this without getting hurt every week. I get hit in the leg with a stick and I'm bruised. Oh, he's running. Ooh, amazing gainage. I think that may be a first down. I am correct. It is a first down. Clay, how do you feel about that play?
Well, I just hope I see more like that. He got a first down, went far, and didn't get tackled until after the first down, which is what we always want.
That is true. What we really want is a touchdown pass. That'd be great. Oh, running play brought down.
If it's on the carry, no gain.
No gain. Still second and ten.
10 yards to go for the Hawks.
Thank you. They're getting ready for what appears to be a play. Oh, given to the running back. Oh, he is gone. That is a first down. First down.
Good for another Southeastern first down.
Thank you. What do you think of that first down, Clay?
Well, like I said with the last first down, hopefully we see more of it. It was good. We went far and got a first down.
I think that was pretty cool the way he got tackled. Not that I wanted to see him get tackled, but that was a still cool tackle. Running back, he's escaping. Oh! That's really close to a first down, if I've ever seen one. Timeout, Warriors. That was a good first down. That was a good play. And a good first down that preceded it. Don't you agree, Clay?
Why, yes I do, Matt. And I must say that the Hawks seem to have really stepped up their offense since the first half. Hopefully they keep it up and aren't just going to run out of their energy in a sort of sugar rush almost thing.
Their coach probably gave him a great pep talk.
Or a lot of pixie sticks.
That's good. Or Skittles. Again, really enthusiastic music that's playing. All right, and the Hawks are back on the field with 6 minutes 43 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
First down and 10 for the Hawks inside the 40-yard line.
It's first down and 10. Oh. Stopped at the line.
David Williams on the carry.
Second and 10. No yards gained.
Loss on the play.
Oh, I am incorrect. Second and 11. I apologize for that mistake. They're having a huddle right now. Discussing a play, probably. They just had a huddle. This is probably going to be one good play. I am correct. Oh, he's running. Ooh, the big guy. Big guy breaks tackles. Gain of 4 yards. Third and 7. Having another huddle. This should be good. Seems every time they huddle,
whistle
time. Timeout, Warriors. A timeout will stop the clock. As I was saying before the timeout was called, it appears that every time Southeastern, the Hawks, huddle, they just come up with a good play and gain yards. Don't you agree?
Well, yes, I do. So perhaps they should huddle up more and hopefully just get into the end zone and score another touchdown and win the game.
That's very good. I'd honestly like to see this go into overtime. Because this is a good game so far. Oh, little guy sprinting. And this is going to be a touchdown. No, it's not. brought down. I'm going to go with brought down at the 7-yard line. 8-yard line. Do believe that was the 8-yard line. Awaiting confirmation. 5 minutes left in the third period. 15 minutes left in the game.
First down and goal to go for Southeastern.
At any time, they could either go for a running play or a throw. Oh, he is through to the end zone. As long as there is no flag on the play, Southeastern has just gained another touchdown.
8-yard touchdown run by Derry's good for a Southeastern touchdown.
That was a good play. Don't you agree, Clay?
Why, yes, I do. We got a touchdown. That is always good.
That was good. Now, we're either going to go for a two-point conversion or a kick. Last time we didn't get the 2-point conversion. I honestly would like for a kickoff, but we're going for the 2-point conversion, and we don't make it.
He does not make the goal line. The point after is no good. Our score with 4.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
4 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the game. Southeastern Hawks, 12. Coyle Cassidy Warriors, 6. We have the lead. First time we've gained the lead in the whole game. And we did it at a pretty opportune time with there only being about 4.5 minutes left in the third. Yeah, 4.5 minutes left in the third. And 4 minutes and 14 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the game itself. What was your opinion of that whole drive, Clay?
Well, it went over well. Had it not, we wouldn't be in the lead right now. Let's just hope that the Hawks' defense are as good as their offense in this second half.
Let's hope. They're going for the kick. They've always had good kicks. And this one is the same. It is gained. He dropped it. And he gets brought down. Ooh. And someone just tried to be a professional wrestler right there. He flipped over that guy. What do you think about that after play result?
Well, it just seemed like a giant mess of bodies all falling upon each other. Someone probably got some sort of bruise that they'll feel in the morning. Hopefully nothing too serious, though.
Yeah, definitely. It's always bad to see an injured player. Even if you're not a fan of the team of the player that gets injured, it's still just saddening to see a player get injured. Oh, someone got tackled immediately. He didn't even have the ball and he got tackled. It was a player on the defensive team got tackled. You don't see that too often.
Short game, second down, 9 yards to go.
It is 2-8 with 4 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in the third period. And the score is Hawks 12, Warriors 6. And with the snap. Oh, sack, fumble. Southeastern recovers. Run for the touchdown. Touchdown. Southeastern off of a sack fumble. That was amazing. Beautiful, beautiful plays. 18-6 Southeastern. 3 minutes, 33 seconds remaining in the third period. We now have a 2-touchdown goal, and we're hoping for either a 2-point conversion or a kick. That touchdown, I believe that touchdown was by Palmer Sullivan. Amazing touchdown, amazing play. That play was worthy of not pronouncing the A in amazing, because that's how good it was. Don't you agree, Clay?
Why, yes, I do. He intercepted the ball and just ran right into the end zone, which is always a good thing to see in this sport for the team that you are cheering for.
I think you meant to say fumble there, Clay. He got the fumble.
Yeah, sorry.
It's all right. We all forgive you. Oh, 2-point conversion is not good. But, hey, you know what? We have a 2-touchdown lead. Who cares? Obviously, the players. Everyone loves points. Unless it's like spam, then no one likes points. One of those spam deals. But I digress, because I don't want to get too off topic. Amazing game of football so far. Cohasset's offense, I mean,
Coyle Cassidy.
I messed up too. I hope you all forgive me for that. Coyle Cassidy's offense deteriorated and they just fumbled. Or, you know what, it might have not been their offense deterioration. It might have been just a good defense, an aggressive defense. And the return of the enthusiastic music. Oh, Warriors drop it. Oh, he got brought down. That had to have hurt. Don't you agree, Clay?
I do not want to be that guy. That had to have hurt. No. No.
I was actually talking about tackles like that earlier. That tackle reminds me of a spear. I'm not going to go into specifics on risk of copyrights, but that reminded me specifically of a wrestler's finishing move that and his name began with an E. I think you all know who we're talking about. It's a good thing that they don't. It's a good thing that they're wearing pads, not that they don't wear pads. Because if they didn't wear pads, that guy might be broken in half. Oh. Short gain. It is. It is 2nd and 7. I apologize for what I think I said. I think I said 3. I apologize for that. It was actually 2. Gain of 2. It's been an amazing game of football. Don't you agree?
Why, yes, I do. We have seen some very amazing and unexpected things from the Hawks and the Warriors, but mostly from the Hawks, which is what I care about because I root for them. It appeared that number 63 accidentally bounced the football off his helmet. Rather entertaining to watch.
Not too good for the offense, though. That was a good play. Well, at least it would have been if it hadn't hit him in the head. But you know what? Both teams are equally deserving of this one because both teams, this is their first game of the season. But the better team's going to win, and I, for one, hope that the better team is Southeastern. Play, deemed dead, may have incomplete pass. You can't see it, but those cheerleaders are doing flips and stuff, and it's amazing. this is going to be like a little bit insight to me. I used to be a diver. I won first place, and I can't do flips like they're doing, so they're pretty amazing. They're going for the kick, and the kick is caught. Oh, nope, dropped. Grab it. Flag on the play.
Ball on the ground.
No, flag on the play. Oh, I withdraw that withdrawal. I 100% withdraw that withdrawal because there is a flag on the play. It appears. But the screen, I can't tell if it is yellow or if it is orange. It is yellow? All right, there is a flag on the play. If you guys remember the replacement refs a couple seasons ago in the NFL, they were kind of funny.
Penalty on Southeastern.
Ooh, the Warriors have the ball.
It'll be first down at the Southeastern 35-yard line.
They may score on this drive. That'll be good. Make the game a little closer. But I can almost guarantee you Southeastern doesn't want the score to be close. They would want this game to be a blowout. And so would any other team. Don't you agree?
Well, yeah. You always want your first game to be a win.
I 100% agree. Unless you plan on not going to the playoffs, then you don't want your first game to be a win. But that's a little random.
Oscar out of the shotgun. In on the tackle for Southeast.
That was just a dog pile.
Second down.
The score is 18 Hawks, 6. Six Warriors with 1 minute 50 seconds remaining in the third period.
Make that second down and seven.
It is second and seven. Run play, and he breaks through. Ooh, brought down.
Costa on the carry, good for a first down, brought down by Andrew McElligott.
That Costa guy is really good, don't you agree?
Well, he appears to be. He ran pretty far before he got knocked down, so he has to be doing something right.
Yeah, he's actually scored. He hasn't scored yet, but he's been a crucial factor in the Warriors' only scoring drive. He's good at running. Very good at running. He's pretty fast and pretty small. He's like greased lightning or greased pig. Ooh, someone just got thrown down. A lot of whistling. Forty seconds remaining in the third quarter. Third and
six.
Oh, sorry. It's second and six. I forgot for a second that they had just scored a first down. I apologize again. Ooh, almost tackled him, and he runs out of bounds, it appears. I am correct. There is 5 seconds remaining. Five flat remaining in the third quarter. And unless they make some amazing play in 5 seconds. Actually, no. Never mind. Unless they score on this next play, it's going into the fourth period with the score 18-6. We're going to find out if it does or if it doesn't. That's actually quite amusing. On the scoreboard, on the bottom of the scoreboard, it's 3-3-3. It's quite amusing. It's the little things. Oh, One. The time is 1.2.
Recovered by Coyle Cassidy. And that'll do it.
Oh. And the third period. Southeastern 18, Coyle Cassidy 6. The end of the third period. And that enthusiastic song is back on. Players are back on the field. They were sort of on the field, but not all the way on the field. Now they're fully back on the field. It is fourth and short. Up. Oh. And they're down.
Straight up the middle. Let's see where they spot the ball.
Sorry. I do believe it is first, not fourth. I misheard. Minutes 56 remaining in this game. It is 18-6 Southeastern Hawks. And unless the Hawks, the officials are measuring, and unless the Hawks have a monumental collapse, they appear to be on their way to win their first game. What do you think, Clay?
Well, you know, there's still one quarter left. The Hawks managed to get two touchdowns in one quarter. So could the Warriors and tie it all up and take us into overtime. But hopefully, the Hawks will come out victorious and win the first game of their season.
Thank you for correcting me about that. I accidentally said their first game like it was their first game ever won. I apologize for that error. That could have been taken as an error. Could have been misleading to the audience. I apologize.
First and 10 for the Hawks.
I was correct. It was a fourth play. Oh, and the Hawks are on offense. Oh, run. He gets brought down, but that was a good run. That may be a first down, but nope, comes up short. I do believe it is second and five. I am correct, it is second and five. 9 minutes, 28 left, first quarter, 18-6 Hawks. Let's hope it stays. Let's hope that margin stays about the same. Nine minutes, 10 left. Play's about to begin. Snap, run, play. Oh, someone was like 10 feet in the air right there.
Carry on the carry.
Clay, what do you think about that?
Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Well, it was just stopped at the line of scrimmage. We have a third down, and hopefully we can just keep moving forward into the end zone without anyone getting hurt from these tackles, because some of them have been pretty rough.
Yeah, especially that one tackle last quarter where the dude just got ran into. That was pretty rough.
Well, it's a dangerous sport, and it happens. These players know the risk, and hopefully they have prevented them with their proper padding and whatnot.
I sure hope so. It's always a shame to see a player get injured, especially early in a season. They could have had so much potential, and it could just be ruined in an instant. Here's the play. Quarterback throws it. It's caught.
Pass toward the sideline.
Incomplete, I believe.
Incomplete.
It'll be fourth down for Southeastern. Fourth down for Southeastern, and they're going to kick it because they are too close to their own goal not to kick it. If they do not kick it, it'll be a monumental mistake. Last quarter, I said it was 3-3-3. Now it's 4-4-4. Look at that. Well, you can't look at that because there's no camera focused on it, but take it from me, it's 4-4-4. The numbers at the bottom are 4-4-4. Take that from me. Just trust me. Timeout Hawks. So, how do you think this whole game's gone so far?
So far, the game's been going pretty good. We're in the lead, so that's always a good thing. However, we are dangerously close to our own end zone. And although we have the ball, it could be easily taken and just ran straight in. We've seen it happen, but we were the ones who were taking the ball. So we were okay with it. Let's hope it doesn't happen the opposite way, because that would be bad.
Well, let's hope that I'm just going to say I believe they're going to punt this ball down the field because they're so close to their own end zone, they can't risk missing it. They can't risk missing the first down. They're just going to punt it. And hopefully their punt doesn't get blocked like what we did to them. The punt isn't blocked, but it doesn't go that far. At about the 47 and a little bit yard line. By a little bit, I mean like inches, not a little bit like miles. Or feet, like slightly, a couple inches. Let's hope the rest of this game is injury-free. Again, can't stress enough. In my opinion, it's always a shame to see a good player get injured, even if they're on the opposing team. Oh, running play, number 9. He's a threat. Ooh, that is the exact kind of tackle I am not a fan of. Getting tackled by the legs, that can hurt a lot. Can mess up your knees, mess up, tear your ACL. That's what happened to Gronkowski. 7 minutes and 30 seconds left in the game. Here go the cheerleaders. One of the cheerleaders appeared to start dying from laughter.
Cheerleader.
7 minutes, 6 seconds left in the game. 18-6 Hawks. And They are back on the field. This should be up. Oh, throw. Ooh. Reverse lateral. That was a good lateral. Gets ran. Not out, out of bounds. That was a nice play. Don't you agree?
Yes, I do. However, they did not get a touchdown. So the Hawks still have a good chance.
I completely agree. I can't wait to see how this game unfolds. Oh, and there's a, he has been stopped. Short gain, 1 or 2 yards. Let's find out. It's second and six. The other team cheerleaders, they have a funny chant. I think it's first and ten. Let's do it again. It's pretty creative. Don't you agree?
Well, you know, a creative mind is a happy mind, and happy minds win games.
So they don't win this one. It is three. It is third and two with 5 minutes and 55 seconds remaining in the game.
Good evening. My name is Dave Deegan, and I am the director of the Technical Institute. On behalf of the administration, students, and staff, I would like to welcome all of you to
tonight's
graduation
ceremony. Neither team has capitalized on the extra point.
I would like to ask Bathsheba Waithaka from our medical...
Oh, there is a pushing war. There is a pushing war, and the pushing war is over.
Short game, close to a first down.
It is fourth. Maybe a first down, may not be. We're about to find out.
It is a Warrior first down.
First down, Warriors, first and 10. I guess those cheerleaders were right, because it was, and I quote, first and 10, and I end quote, and I guarantee they want to quote, do it again, end quote. I have a feeling they're going to score on this drive, mainly just because our defense has been a little bit sloppy this play. Oh, he's about to get sacked. Last time he got sacked, he fumbled.
Sack behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of five on the play.
It is now second and 15. With 4 minutes, 55 seconds remaining, 18-6, Hawks. What was your opinion on that play, Clay?
Well, the Warriors lost 5 yards, so the Hawks did pick up their defense, and hopefully they will keep it up.
I 100% agree. Who knows? We might get another sack and a fumble again. Return that for another touchdown. We'd be all set. We'd be in cruise control.
We have a
timeout. Nope. Not whistle. Oh, timeout Southeastern. I was correct. I have to stop doubting myself. I wonder what this enthusiastic track is. I think it may just be Bells.
It's an AC/DC song called Hell's Bells.
Oh, it's an AC/DC song. It's Hell's Bells. Thanks, Clay, for telling me that. I didn't know what it was. This has been a long time out or just a slow song. A little off topic. I thought it was going to be hot in here at the end of the day, but it's pretty cold, and I like it. All right, here's the play. Oh, caught, dropped. Nope, play's dead. Loss of yards. I am incorrect. It was not a loss of yards. I actually thought he had caught it. It looked like he had caught it and then messed up a little bit. I was wrong. 4 minutes, 46 seconds remaining in the game. Hawks 18, Warriors 6. Third and some up. Quarterback sacked. Boys. Tibbetts has game, don't you agree?
Yes, I do. Tibbetts has always been good. I've played sports with him before. It's not fun to get hit by him in practice.
Well, I'd assume he's sacking people left and right. He'd be pretty good at sacking. Here's more AC/DC. The wire just hit my hand and it scared me for a second. Plays back on. Oh, Hail Mary. Intercepted. Hail Mary intercepted. Oh, never mind. Incorrect. I, for one, believe that there could have been good grounds on a offensive pass interference right there, because I think he got pushed when he was catching it, but I'm not at the best angle to see that, so might not have. Returning to the line of scrimmage now. Do believe Hawks have possession of the ball. They do. Oh, running play. Stiff-armed. He's going to make it. He's done. Oh, almost gone. Amazing play. Amazing play, amazing game. What was your opinion on that, Clay?
Well, it was great. We made it past the 50-yard line. Southeastern is still in possession of the ball, and with such a short amount of time of just over 3 minutes left, and with us in this kind of lead, it's looking good for the Hawks.
Yeah. I think right now we could turn on cruise control if we want, but we don't necessarily need to. We can just keep going for more points. All right. At the line of scrimmage again. Now, we actually have a really good angle for this. Oh. Made it right past the 45-yard line. Most likely a gain of 5 onto the 45-yard line. That's most likely where the line of scrimmage is going to be. Oh, no gain. Second and 10. There's a huddle going on right now. The other team's waiting impatiently. Southeastern's probably trying to drain the clock as much as possible so that they have The other team has less of a chance for a comeback. Oh, running play again. Oh, he is gone. Ooh, he got hit. He is still going. Broken tackle. Thrown down at about the 25-yard line. At about the 25-yard line, I think he was thrown down somewhere around there. That was good for another Hawks first down. More enthusiastic music. Enthusiastic music's over. Now it's time to get back to the game. Cheerleaders want a touchdown. They might be about to get one. He is just breaking tackles left and right. Clay, what do you think about that? Because that was amazing in my eyes.
It looked amazing to me too, Matt. We just got another first down from it. We're pretty close. Ooh, and there's a whistle.
Injured player. This is exactly what I did not want to happen. 1 minute, 17 seconds left. He looks hurt bad. Could be a knee issue. Maybe high thigh. Here's some enthusiastic music while we see what's going on. He's now being helped off the field. This does not look good. He's okay, but he is limping. I think that might have been a tackle that was not that good. I mean, I didn't really see it that well. Clay, did you see it good?
Well, I have a similar view to you, but in the end, he was able to walk, so it couldn't have been too bad.
Yeah, I think. I hope it wasn't too bad. Because that kid's future looks bright. Because next year, I do believe he is going to college because he is a senior. 40 seconds left, 18 and 6.
Victory formation play. No game.
Victory is imminent. Victory formation play is also imminent.
30 seconds left. Second down and 10.
25 left. 20 left. 15, victory formation play.
No gain on the play.
That was Southeastern's won it, 18-6. My name is Matthew Barboza. And
I'm Clay Thompson. The Southeastern Hawks just won their first game of the season of 18-6. Hopefully, it's a win that'll carry them through the series.
And I hope that this game brings them momentum. I hope you join us next week as we will be announcing the next game. The Warriors lose 18-6, Hawks win 18-6. Hope to see you again next week. My name is Matthew Barboza, and I shall see you next week.